I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with Dan Haneckaw, book buyer for Powell's Books at Cedar Hills Crossing, as well as creator of the Portland history blog at CafeUnknown.com. We were talking about protests against authors and books. Sometimes, in broad terms, it's a genre or it's a category of books. Sometimes it's very specific, as was the case with Salman Rushdie some years back, which I think we're actually now talking almost 20 years ago.
It was a long time ago. The original Powell's Beaverton store out near Washington Square, there was that international controversy about the satanic verses, and Powell's was very concerned about the outcry that was going on, and there were certain contingencies and thoughts about what would happen if the Burnside store was threatened. And actually it was the Beaverton store that got the phone calls that said that if you carry this book, there will be trouble.
Maybe they were working up. Maybe they figured it was like an entry-level threat, and then they'd sort of escalate as their means allowed them to.
Yeah, so we actually had real bomb threats, whereas Burnside, not a thing.
And this, it's been so long, actually, since this original controversy that it all sort of washes together, through the mists of memory. But it was some weeks, if not months, that this raged on in the public eye. And, of course, for Rushdie himself, there was a death sentence. A penalty on his head that I don't know if that's still in effect. I don't know if that was ever...
I heard it's lifted.
That, lapses after a while.
Yeah, no,
it
was not renewed.
So, sort of like cheese that eventually goes bad in the fridge, and it just sort of, it lapses. But he... I believe last year, or maybe earlier this year, returned to Portland, to Beaverton.
He came to our store, and I don't know if there was anybody in the store that night that actually worked through that first incident 20 years ago, but it was kind of this closing of the circle that our store had him, and it was a hugely attended event. Probably our biggest literature event for that genre that we had.
What were his thoughts on it? What did he have to say about, because obviously he can't, that the fatwa or the death penalty that was put on his head for writing that book, that's sort of his free bird. He kind of can't go anywhere without performing that. He has to talk about it.
Actually, it seemed like it was the elephant in the room. He was more into the book, the latest
right.
thing he was doing. And I don't know if it would be considered rude to bring it up, or I didn't recall him actually talking about that.
Was there a palpable tension in the air?
I don't think so. And that kind of, from just a, you're working in a bookstore and there's an event and, you factor in everything. There just didn't seem to be. It seemed a nice evening.
That's such a disappointing answer. I really wasn't hoping that there was open gunplay in the store, but I was at least thinking that there would be the guys in the black suits kind of talking into their wrist and pointing out suspicious
individuals. If there were, they were really good, and we didn't see them.
Well, I'm going to choose to believe that that's how it happened. That was, 20 years ago, and as you said, it does come full circle, and those things come in and out of fashion as far as protests go. In the 80s, everything seemed to be fear of the occult, and that, I think, has returned in some way, especially with books aimed at children or young adults. From what you've seen, your experience in Portland, in Oregon, or perhaps beyond, what are the most frequently challenged recent books? Books of, let's say, the past year, 5 years, 10 years, that people have latched onto?
The one a number of the librarians talked about was a fairly recent book, 2005, called And Tango Makes Three, and it's a kid's book, basically about a little family of penguins that lived in the Central Park Zoo, based on a true story where two male penguins hatched an egg. They were obviously taking care of an egg. The zookeepers gave them a live one, so to speak, and the penguin hatched, and they raised it as if it was just, what they do. And so the kid's book is made of it, but it is sort of Tango Has Two Daddies.
It's the gay.
And so with that... there has been, and it could very well be something that got some national press. It's not been banned in Portland. It was just something that they mentioned that they had received some calls about, some concern about.
When you work at a bookstore, and I imagine this is probably the same at bookstores of whatever stripe, does the word sort of go out internally on some level, or is there a bit of a whisper about we've got this book on aisle 17, you may want to be watching for, angry people to come in about it, or is it Or are you even aware of potential controversies before they pop up on the radar?
I would say where you hear about things like that telegraphing the most would be at the used book buyer's counter, where it's like, keep an eye out for, you know, something's going to be on TV, somebody died, controversy, whatever thing that might make a book that is previously not in demand and on the horizon could change.
Okay, I'm so glad you brought this up. So this is a chance to answer a question that I have always wondered, if you can speak to this. If a celebrity is found, just he's in a hotel room and he's, you know, clearly not going to get up anytime soon, is somebody immediately on the phone going, I need more Chris Farley books, stat?
It definitely gets around. You know, you say, you know, someone died. We don't know if there's going to be a death bounce or not, but...
A death bounce? That is fantastic. A death bounce sounds like something that Quincy would have talked about on the Medical Examiner show. Boy, I'm dating myself with that reference. A death bounce sounds like something that David Caruso would say on CSI Miami before taking off his glasses. All right. When we come back, we'll close the book on this section of... No, we won't do that. We'll continue talking to Dan Haneckaw. We will also talk about your Portland history blog when we return. This is Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there.